A journey to my soul, but the police just pulled me over. It's kind of funny if you think about the fact that I wasn't even driving, but seated at my desk, yet apparently I was speeding 30, 40, 50 light years past the speed limit, and I didn't even realize it. See, I've been doing this poetry so long, I actually thought I could find myself through it. Going back, the proverbial return, where my ego and self reform their original wholeness. I just have to look past all these mass murderers that masquerade as teachers and leaders, killing my dreams of self-knowledge with images of destruction and fear. Coding my subconscious has got my unconscious in a fit. It makes me nervous just to go out in public. It gives me nightmares until I have to sit here and write them away. But I think my computer must be bugged. I think my computer must be bugged, cause I was on a journey to my soul, but the police just pulled me over. They asked me if I knew anything or anyone who had served in the military of another country or who had acted peculiar or maybe even celebrated the day terrorists blew up the WTC. I said, wait, please don't ask me another question about where I'm from or how I got here. See, I was on a journey to my soul, but somehow I landed in jail. And I don't mean behind bars in the pen, cause this prison lives in the mind. Fronts as paradise, depresses the imagination, locks up creativity with the simple stroke of government ink. Religious fervor, political righteousness, public frenzy makes victim every freedom it used to preach. Frozen investments that kill teachers and poets, whose inspiration relies on the community's faith, not the government's pocket. See, I used to write books, now I study the stock market, wondering which company's crash will lead to more military spending. See, I know that budgets are casualties, but the spirit is bleeding. I was on a journey to my soul, now they're going through my ID. They noticed I had a Slavic name and started to ask me about when my family immigrated to the United States. I said, during World War II, my grandfather was an anti-communist Chetnik who fought the Germans and Russians in Yugoslavia before he had to escape to Italy, before he made it to England, where he met my German grandmother, and together they immigrated to the steel mills of Gary. Gary, Indiana? Yeah, not Montana, Paris, France, or Rome, but Gary, Indiana. You know the place that sang about, the place the Jackson 5 left, that all-American place that became the murder capital of the United States. But that's not me. I'm from California, Chula Vista, near the Mexican border. I'm not an illegal alien, but my mother came to California to escape my father. She is Mexican and Cuban, born here. Her parents immigrated from Jalisco, Mexico, y La Habana, Cuba. Mira chico, no te diste cuenta que yo soy cubano. A mí me gusta cha-cha-cha, salsa swing, ya no te dije. Pero también soy chicano, and we died in your wars. So unless you want me to call 23 million of my closest friends and boycott your ass, you better leave me alone. Think of all the grapes that won't get picked. Think of your life without orange juice. I know how important regular digestion is to you people. See, I was on a journey to my soul, but now you got me started. Now you got us all started. It's gonna take more than a ticket to teach me a lesson. Your schools were torture enough, and deportation only spreads the disease. Dis-ease within America. No safe way to keep track of who's coming and going. Spreading America. Spreading America all over the world. Spreading America all over the place. Until there are no foreigners left.